figures with two lines of symmetry. Even the figure, when it is cut horizontally or vertically, the given picture will be in symmetrical format. Okay, that is the meaning of figures with two lines. What are the two lines? The line may be horizontal or it might be vertical. Figures with multiple, that means more than two lines of symmetry. Scissor is the best example. If you can cut this one at any part, we are going to get the symmetry. Observe carefully how it is going to change. See the picture. The letters E and E. This is one more example for figures with multiple, that means more than two lines of symmetry. See this one. See this one, how it is cutted. See this one. These are the examples with two line symmetry. A rhombus can be divided horizontally as well as vertically, and it also forms the line of symmetry. Okay. Next. Exercise 13.2. Observe these pictures carefully. Find the number of lines of symmetry for each of the following shapes. For question A, see, there are four symmetric lines called as L, this is line M, this is line N, this is line O. So here we have four symmetrical lines. And for this picture B, in this picture also there are four symmetrical lines. See, this is line P, line Q, line R and line S. Next, question C. In this shape, we have four lines of symmetry. U is the one line, V, W and X. Okay. If you can see this picture, only M is the line of symmetry. That is, cut this picture into two halves with the help of the line M, which is cut in the vertical shape. Next. Question E. Here we have six lines of symmetry. Even though we cut this figure into six shapes, it will be in the symmetrical format. The lines are A, B, C, D is one more line, E and F is the final line. How these, you can see how these lines are cut in this picture. Okay. Even for picture F is also, we can cut into six lines. See. Observe this picture carefully. Picture F. How many lines are there? Six lines. What are they? L, M, tell me, N, O, P and Q. These are the six lines of symmetry. G. This figure has no lines of symmetry. Observe carefully. And also, this picture has no lines of symmetry. Next. This figure has five lines of symmetry. Observe these four lines. Okay. These are the lines. Line L1, line L2, L3, L4 and L5. This figure has five lines of symmetry. Question number 2. Copy the triangle in each of the following figures on a squared paper. In each case, draw line or lines of symmetry. If any, and identify the type of triangle. Okay? See this one. Here it was placed. This is the picture. So, for question A, it is an isosceles triangle having one symmetric line. I think you remembered what is an isosceles triangle with one symmetric line. And even question B is also, it is an isosceles triangle only with one symmetric line. Okay. Question C, it is an isosceles right angle triangle. If you can see, this is isosceles right angle triangle, and which has, when it is the line is cut like this, it has only one symmetric line. And for question D, if you can observe the picture, it is a scalene triangle and it has no symmetric line. Scalene triangle doesn't have in any symmetric line. Question number 3. Complete the following table. Shape, rough figure and number of lines of symmetry. He was given the example. If for equilateral triangle, we have, this is the rough figure and the number of lines of symmetry are 3. That means we have 3 lines of symmetry. And for a square, check it out, how many lines we have? Line 1, line 2, line 3, line 4. 4. And for a rectangle, of course, we can guess easily. We have only 2 lines, line 1 and line 2. For an isosceles triangle, cut it into half, we have only 1 line. For the rhombus, it is, we have 2 lines, line 1 and line 2. For a circle, we may have infinite number of lines of symmetry. How beautiful to see this one. We have infinite number of lines of symmetry for a circle. Okay. Next. Question number 4. Can you draw a triangle which has exactly one line of symmetry and exactly 2 lines of symmetry and exactly 3 lines of symmetry? For question A, an isosceles right angle triangle has exactly 1 line of symmetry. Okay. And 2 lines of symmetry, we cannot draw a diagram. Okay. And for question C, an equilateral triangle has 3 lines of symmetry. They are line L, line M and line N. Okay? And for D, no lines of symmetry. A scalene triangle has no lines of symmetry. Next. Question 5. On a squared paper, sketch the following. Question A. A triangle with a horizontal line of symmetry but no vertical line of symmetry. See, this is a triangle. This figure shows an isosceles triangle with a horizontal line of symmetry. This is the answer for question A. Question B. A quadrilateral which has both horizontal as well as vertical lines of symmetry. A rectangle has both horizontal as well as vertical. We have line N and line M, two lines of symmetry. And question C. A quadrilateral which has horizontal line of symmetry but no vertical line of symmetry. That means here we have a trapezium. This is a quadrilateral. It shows the horizontal but no vertical line of symmetry. Question D. A hexagon with exactly two lines of symmetry. And question E. A hexagon with six lines of symmetry. See, for the question D, the answer is a hexagon drawn below shows only two lines of symmetry. This is the shape. And for question E, the regular hexagon has six lines of symmetry. Observe the picture carefully. Observe these two pictures carefully. Next, question 6. Trace each figure and draw the lines of symmetry, if any. Question A. This given picture has no lines of symmetry because it is not symmetrical. And question B. This given picture has two lines of symmetry. And for question C. The given picture has four lines of symmetry. Line 1, line 2, line 3, line 4. And this given picture has only two lines of symmetry. One is horizontal and one is vertical. This figure has only one horizontal line of symmetry as shown. And the given picture has two lines of symmetry. One is horizontal. Tell me, the other one is vertical. For these pictures. Question number 7. Consider the letters of English alphabets A to Z. List among them the letters which have vertical lines of symmetry, horizontal lines of symmetry, and no lines of symmetry. The following letters have vertical lines of symmetry. A. Students draw these letters in bigger size and try to prove them. Okay, this is your homework. But I am giving you the answer. You have to do the work. The following letters have vertical lines of symmetry. They are A, H, I, M, O, T, U, V, W, X and Y. Okay. And for question B, the following letters have a horizontal line of symmetry. B, C, D, E, H, I, K, O and X. I think you know what is an horizontal line and what is an vertical line. And how to cut the letter. Horizontal, you should have to cut like this. And vertical, you have to cut the particular letter like this, straight away from top to bottom. And horizontal is from left to right. And question C. The following letters have no lines of symmetry. They are F. If you can cut these letters horizontally or vertically, you will not find any line of symmetry. They are F, Z, J, L, N, P, Q, R, S and Z. Question number 8. Given here the figures of a few folded sheets. Okay, these are the folded sheets, if you can observe. And designs drawn about the fold. In each case, draw a rough diagram of the complete figure that would be seen when the design is cut half. Okay. The given figures will be seen as follows. See here, this picture will be like this, and this will be like this. And for the picture 1, if we can draw the line vertically, the left side part and right side part shows the symmetry. And for this picture, if we can draw a line horizontally, the top of the picture as well as the right bottom of the picture shows the line of symmetry. Next, with this we have completed this exercise. Thank you.